And we've got another PSA reveal. Some great cards in here. Overall, happy with the order. This was from the January special. This was a 32 card order. First 19 cards we'll show are going to be mine, and then the 13 cards. We'll show the card prices, what we paid raw, and estimated values on these first 19 cards. The last 13 cards are a buddy of mine, so I don't really know the cost of and values. I didn't look those up, but have some good results from his order as well. But starting us off here, and we'll post the submission date, when they were received, and of course we just got them back. I think it was about a month overall, door to door, so which is pretty respectable for PSA. I imagine as the major specials, are delayed, we'll probably start to see the turnarounds times improve even further. Like to see those in that 2 to 4 week time frame, which would be great to continue to get those from PSA. But first one up is going to be base prism, Aiden O'Donnell. Pulled the gem in on that one. And really didn't have any duds in the order. Anytime I get cards back and we can get 9s and 10 throughout the order, that's a success. So really cool card here, the SPX. Got a mint 9. Thought this one had an off chance at a 10, but obviously those older paper cards where the back borders and things can sometimes be a little bit prone to chipping. Make it tougher, but happy with the 9 on that one. 9 mint on this one. Cool on-card auto for Hines Ward from Skybox Premium. 9 mint. This is one, actually, there was some type of weird... You can kind of see it right there on his jersey. That's actually on the card, so I had this pre-graded at a 7 or an 8, as I wasn't entirely sure how much of an impact, if any, it would have. So apparently PSA felt that it was still worthy of a 9, so I was excited about that. Got a gem mint on the laser, Bryce Young. Did really well on all the prism cards in this order. Obviously, you know, I pre-screen them pretty heavily, so try and weed out the duds from making it in. But nonetheless, you know, from what I've been buying or opening, this year's prism is a lot better, at least on the surface. Centering, of course, you always got to be mindful of. Here's a big hit. Got a gem mint on this one, base prism. Nine mint on the playoff contenders, Jordy Nelson. I might write on this one because this could be a snap out and resend. I was really confident of a 10. So, you know, nine mint still okay for this card, but really, you know, need a 10 to make a lofty premium and be really sought after, in my opinion, if I was to look to sell it. So at some point down the road, so. Given I know that this is a high quality condition card, I might crack that one out at some point. Then we got first Anthony Richardson base prism. We got gem mint 10. Followed by a Khalil Mack upper deck star rookies mint 9. I think this was our only 9 for Richardson, so this one pulled the 9 mint base prism. Here's a banger. You got the Disco CJ Stroud. Again, we'll have the prices up here, what, you know, estimated current comps are on these cards. I imagine Stroud's stuff will continue to only increase as we draw closer to start of the season. So always the question of, you know, holding, you know, probably we've got a handful of CJ Stroud stuff in this order, so we'll probably list some, maybe hold back about 2 of the Strouds and look to sell those closer to the season, as I imagine again the prices might increase over time here. So numbered out of 449, This one here got the mint 9 for Gordon Hayward. Don't think he's getting seeing the floor all that much. Not sure if he's fully healthy yet or still kind of figuring out his place in the rotation there on OKC. But got another gem mint on the base prism, CJ. I think those are doing 150 to 175 currently, roughly. Beautiful red, white, blue Cade Cunningham. Also pulled the gem mint. Aiden O'Connell. Luckily, all the Aidens in this order, gem mint. Otherwise, we'd be probably losing, although I think all these were pack pulled, at least for Aiden O'Connell. So, but nice disco. Happy with this one. This is the Rated Rookies portrait. Got the gem mint. Always nice when you can, you know, you buy these raw in the wild. This was at a card show, actually, you know, and able to send them in to get graded and get that premium by getting the gem mint. So obviously same thing with eBay, you know, scouring over cards to be able to get the gem mints. Just takes a good eye and patience. But next Richardson base prism, got a gem mint on this one as well. Cool Christian McCaffrey, Panini Classics, that is. This is probably a $50-$60 card. Not a ton of value, but I think I only paid a few bucks for the card. So two cards left for us. This is just a throwback. Drew Bledsoe, rookie sensations, got the mint 9. Really thought this had a chance at a 10, so unfortunately this grader on this day did not give it to me. So, and then the final card for us, at least on our portion of the order, is going to be the Matthew Stafford the three patch. Beautiful card. This one actually surprised me on the upside, so I thought this one was going to be a 7 or 8, so I'm pleasantly surprised that we pulled the 9, numbered out of 50. Alright, so let me move my stack out of the way. Alright, here we go. Good luck. We got first one up, 2002 Bowman Chrome, Matt Cain. This is at X-Fractor, near mint 8. Let me get that one. All right, and this one pulled to 7. This is Orange Refractor rookie card for Travis Kelce. It did have, you know, surface scratches and things of that nature. So new on this one. Most of these, for the most part, you know, came in line with my pre-grades that I sent over to him. Some one or maybe two grades higher on a couple of the cards. So we got a 7 on the Kelce. Cool one here, Domingo German. Mint 9, Red Refractor. Followed by Dallas Braden. This is also a Red Refractor, Mint 9. And is Jordan Love, Green Mosaic, pulled the gem, Mint 10. All right, couple Richardsons coming up. First one is a laser. Got the mint 9. And the biggest card for him in the order, you guessed it, Richardson silver, boom, gem mint 10. So nice solid hit on this one. I think that's doing about 450-ish. Here we go, Roy Holiday. Refractor, near mint 7 from Bowman Chrome. And you can see why, obviously centering played a big part in the grade. Surface and everything else was pretty solid, but set, you know, centering, you can see is where we got knocked on that one. CJ Stroud, this is the blue reactive NFL debut. Gem mint. And then the final four cards are going to be Mr. Brock Purdy. Got the holo. This is probably a pretty solid big card. Gem Mint 10. And then three bases. So we got a Mint 9. And then solid, followed by two Gem Mints. So these are pretty liquid, I imagine. So even in those bases. So that does it. Overall, again, pleasantly, or not pleasantly surprised, but happy overall with the order. Appreciate you guys watching. Of course, as always, make sure to smash that like button for us. Feel free to leave any comments below as well. We'll see you on the next order. Thanks.